sorry, this is, how's that? I don't know, I said to the people last day, but I'm like to say, I'm getting a little surprised, like, about talking about Christian history, here, when, Brother Spiro and others are so professional about it, and I'm just a very amateur. But, I think it's extremely useful and also very interesting to look back in this way. And, I'd like to introduce the general discussion, which you might think about, with a remark that the famous theologian Peter Medawar made about, in general, scientists not being very interested in the history of science, because in a way, that is the embodied in the present state of knowledge of the science. Nonetheless, I think it's worth thinking about that. And so that's exactly what I'd like to do. And I'm going to take some liberties with the state 1890 and look at the state of physics, both had your test itself. Something I had quite a bit to say. Said that he really didn't understand what the Maxwell was saying in physical terms. And the distinguished physicist, who I think may have been a student of Maxwell, said much the same thing. I understand all of Maxwell except what he means by a child's body, something that you think of, but that's the basis for the subject. Now, one thing in particular that came into here then was the concept, Maxwell's concept of electrical displacement, even in a vacuum. That was something that people had a hard time with. And with Maxwell, seemed to have a genuine fondness for. So that he wrote in this treatise that something that we teach all the time, in one way or another, that the concept of an electric circuit, even with a capacitor in it, is a complete circuit. And here, I found it great intriguing that the displacement current might be measured, Maxwell says, with a tentative galvanoid that seems to be connected. I wondered how on earth he could imagine where it can connect. I don't know if somebody suggested about that, but I've puzzled over this. Anyhow, problems like this persisted. And here, finally, I think, took a very modern view of all of this, that one doesn't need the very artificial physical pictures necessarily in order to appreciate and accept Maxwell's equations itself. Now, there was Maxwell's theory in 1864. He, as soon as he had worked it out, he understood that here was a clue to the possible nature of life and said as much. And everybody was very excited about it. Curiously, he did not go on to organize or do any experiments on recognizing the electrical system to look for the electromagnetic wave under conditions of electric circuit. And of course it was Heinrich Hertz who then did that in a triumphant way. There were some forerunners, or could have been. One finds sad stories in physics when one thinks back in this way. There was an American living in Ireland by the name of Hughes, who in about 1880 had done some measurements in which he picked up electrical signals at a distance of 500 yards from the source. And he got to George Stokes to go and look at it. And Stokes said, oh, that's in touch. And that's sort of that. So that Hertz doesn't get the credit for So this was a high point in history of just before the year 1890, certainly legitimately within the period I just talked about. There was somebody else who actually came close to duplicating some of the results, or some of them, at about the same time. And that was Oliver Lodge, British physicist, whom I'll have to give you more to say later. I don't know how many of you are familiar with the book by Condon and Shortley, which many of us used as a sort of textbook of the quantum theory of radiation many years ago. But I have never forgotten the fact that the heading of one of the chapters was Oliver Lodge, the whole theory of radiation seems to be working itself out splendidly. This was in 1888. Lodge had just been doing experiments with parallel wires and seeing sparks at the ends of wires with resonant effects depending upon the length of the wire. Just as he was sending the paper to press, he read Helmholtz's papers demonstrating the propagation of electromagnetic waves in through space. And at the very end, the last sentence, was this business about the whole theory of radiation working itself out splendidly. I think because it's not being put in a very ironic way, because clearly the whole theory of radiation was turned upside down by the appearance of the quantum theory. But at the time, well, of course, the practical application of electromagnetism didn't have to wait for the elaboration of Maxwell's theories and the further development by Hertz and others. And I'd just like to remind you that one can go a long way back and still find practical applications of electromagnetism very soon after Faraday. So that